Text Plus Node isn't just a simple little title bot. It's the foundation of all cinematic titles, and most editors only use 10% of its power. Check out these 5 savage tips that will blow your animations into the next level. No plugins, no 3D, just the Text Plus Node. Let's dive in. All right, first up, we have the layout modes. Now, you know about the new text box layout mode that will conform your text into whatever shape box you want. But my favorite is the point mode. It basically puts it on a polymask line that you can animate. You can even have it right on the line and change its perspective like it's zigzagging through your scene. Honorable mention is the circle layout. Easily have it animate around floating objects or somebody's head if you want. There's lots of things you can do with this layout mode. You just gotta use your imagination. Next up, the shading tab. Now, I know you know about the shading tab and how to add a stroke. Have you ever really thought about how to use them? Check out the comic title that comes with DaVinci Resolve. Yeah, click all these on and you got a 3D title. Customize the shading tabs how you want, or dig in and figure out how it's built and make your own custom fake 3D title. Possibilities are endless. Next up, character level styling. Now, I know you pros out there already know about this, but the newbies, I doubt it. This is how you change single words or even single letters, font, size, color, you name it. Character level styling will let you bring your text game to the next level. Next up, the follower modifier. Something else you can combine with character level styling. You can have all your characters animate on letter by letter, word by word, or even line by line. Customize your delay, how it animates, left, right, in, out, completely random. There's a ton of things you can do with the follower modifier and really spice up your animations. I guarantee a lot of you didn't know this. You can actually use expressions in the text box. So first off, we're gonna click our template node. We're gonna right click, we're gonna edit controls. And then we're gonna add a slider control to our text plus. Then we're gonna right click our text box and hit expression. Now we're gonna pick whip this down to our slider control. Now our text is gonna show whatever number our slider control is on, and we can keyframe this. Need a death counter, a timer. This is the easiest way to do it. It's super simple. I bet none of you had any idea. Now take these 5 tips and put them all together and make something really awesome. If you didn't know these 5 tricks before, hit that like button. If you knew 3 or more, congratulations, you're already leveling up. Subscribe for more in-depth Fusion tutorials that dive into the creative side of editing. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one.